Yes.
Nope.
Oh.
Miss.
No. What did I say? E5?
Yeah. F5.
Miss. F1.
Miss.
You know who I hate?
A3.
Miss? Who?
I hate Zane.
Why?
I don't know. He's probably nice to you because, you know, you're the co-host and you go to dinner and stuff, right?
Yeah, occasionally we'll go to B-Dubs, watch the game.
I feel like he just does that because, you know, you're the co-host. I don't know. He just treats the rest of us like we're nothing. It's like we don't have talent. We're nothing.
I don't believe that. G7?
Miss.
Speaking of missing, I stole this girl's shampoo last night. Shampoo and conditioner. I used it. My hair is remarkably soft.
You know what? I'm sick of you talking about hair just because I don't have any, all right? I'm glad I cut my hair.
Okay.
I did it for a good reason. Well, I'm very happy for it.
I wish I could have done it for a good reason.
Oh, why didn't you?
Because it's just too glorious.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Whatever.
J6.
Hit.
Ooh, right in the kisser.
Yeah.
Hey, you know what we talked about earlier?
That thing that'd be really funny if you did it on the show.
Yeah, what about it?
Let's say if I win, you gotta do it.
Okay. Alright, but if I win, you gotta clean your head with the toilet bowl.
With the toilet bowl?
Mm-hmm.
I just got this thing shaved.
What I know, it's like a little scrubber. You know, those little pads that have like really...
I think I hit my head this morning. I might have a cut on there, you know?
That's not my problem.
All right, whatever. So let's see here. J6?
Yeah, hit.
Ah, Timmy. Why are we even playing out here? You know my head burns easily.
Yeah, shouldn't we be playing Battleship in a pool?
Timmy, don't you remember the last time we tried to play Risk in a pool?
Well, it's not risky if you're not in the deep end.
Whatever. J5.
Hits. That's all of them. You got them.
What the f***, Timmy? You can't stack all the battleships up like that.
Why not?
Because it's... I won. I'm sick of your shit.
Hey, Pictionary on Tuesday.
Schaefer, Caleb Day, Simon Poing, Tim McBride, and your host, Zane Gooselderly. On tonight's show, an undecided voter. With special guest, Jawan Edwards. And now, live from Ball State University, it's BSU Tonight.
It is good to be here.
And it's warm.
That's enough. Thank you. We don't want to turn into the Big Bang Theory with the awful laugh audience track, okay? Thank you, guys. It's wonderful to have you. We have a large audience today. The folks from Brayton Clevenger decided to show up and support us, all from floor 2. That's right. No one from floor 3. We have no respect for any of you.
I'm from floor
4. Yeah, I know. No, okay. None respect all right, whatsoever.
All right, whatever.
Awesome show we've got today. We've got a really cool guest. We've got an interesting segment coming up. We've got a cool monologue. We've got everything going for us. The weather's still going on. Is there anything bad that could be happening right now?
Not at all.
Syria.
Syria.
See, folks, Timmy just doesn't really know how to read the headlines as much, and so this is just me kind of stepping in and educating you one step at a time.
Okay, what's going on with Syria?
A lot, Timmy.
Oh,
a lot that doesn't need to be on a comedy talk show right now, okay?
I'm glad you brought it up.
And our hearts go out to all of them. Let's start with something funny and move away from this.
You want to start it right now?
Sorry?
Right. Okay. Jeb Bush endorsed Mitt Romney last Wednesday, saying he's seen him as the perfect candidate to be elected to office. That said, the Romney camp has taken note to not get too excited
because getting endorsed by Jeb is like being a student body political group named Velocity and getting endorsed by the Ball State Daily News. It doesn't mean jack, and you'll most end up likely losing.
Who the f*** wrote that? Huh? Huh? Was it Luke? Huh? I want to know who did it, all right? I want to find that conniving son of a bitch, all right? Because when I get through with him, all right, nothing. He's done, all right? Let that be a lesson to all of you. You too over there, Brayton Clevenger, all right? You'll be out!
All right. You know, it wasn't him. It was one of those helpless, unskilled, limited talent things. What are they? Writers?
Yeah, those rats.
Yeah.
Rats, okay? They're rats because they don't shower, they're not hygienic, and then they think, oh, let me go poke at other people. I'll tell you something, it takes a lot of galls to run, okay? Win or lose. So I don't care what anyone has to say, I don't care, it's a little joke and a monologue. You know, I'm a good sport, I could take it, but I'll have your job right after I take your balls, okay? All right, that's pretty good.
Well then, on a cheery note, let's move on.
I'd rather talk about Syria right now, okay? I'd rather talk about Syria. Go ahead.
You want to know who wrote that joke?
I'll get him. It's fine. All right. Women's college basketball was a buzz this week after the Baylor Bears played a player, Brittany Griner, dunked during her team's NCAA tournament game, becoming only the second woman ever to do so.
Wait. They're excited because she dunked the ball.
So funny, I don't understand.
I mean, it's like if you got super excited over being able to scratch your butt. People do it every day. Just watch the NBA, people. Actually, someone, please watch the NBA.
Really, they need some support.
Because
right
nobody
now.
Is. But seriously, though, what do these women athletes want? A cookie? She can have a cookie, but she's going to have to bake it herself.
Oh, God, did you feel that?
What's wrong?
I just felt the weight of 1,000 death stares coming through that camera. Top of the form, our own Peyton Manning has a new home with the Denver Broncos last week, taking over the quarterback position from Tim Tebow. While certain analysis says that this will be the death of Tebow mania, fans of his can expect God to perform a resurrection on his career, or at least that they can hope.
They hope. Word is Oprah Winfrey laid off 1/5 of her staff last Tuesday. Past employees say this is Oprah's annual occurrence of laying off a fraction of the people in relation to the amount of weight she gains in a week.
Ah, that's clever. That's good. I really hope she's not doing that kind of thing because that would just be
awful.
That'd
be awful, yeah.
Yeah, it would be pretty bad. A study was released last Monday that shows meth use during pregnancy causes behavioral problems for the child. In response to that story, a separate journal article was created entitled No Shit, Sherlock. I mean, come on.
This past week, news broke out that Sweden could be moving towards a cashless economy. Initial plans called for the income to be represented by chocolate, which only pissed off the Belgians more.
That's, you know, they really don't like to mess with anything
they love
other
their
than
chocolate.
Their chocolate. If you haven't heard about the new blockbuster from Disney entitled John Carter, you're just like everyone else.
What is it?
Exactly.
Oh.
With a budget of $250 million, the film was sought to be a huge success, but appears to have done the complete opposite, as it was projected that the film itself would lose the Disney Corporation $2 million.
$200 million.
Thank you.
Yeah.
We've said it on the show before.
I mean, two million would be... numbers.
But yes, that is correct. $200 million for the Disney Corporation. Yeah, $2 million.
$2 million. It's like pockets change.
Peanuts for Dumbo. This brings us to our top 10 list of the week. That's right. The top 10 things Disney could have done with $200 million they lost on John Carter. Timmy, start us off at number 10.
I'd like them to eliminate those damn latches off the sides of the DVD boxes.
That's right.
I mean, I'm breaking my fingernails.
Across the country are bleeding. Number 9, endorse one of the cartoon characters running in the GOP primary.
Number 8, build Disneyland Sudan.
Don't laugh. It's a good idea. I think it's a great idea. Number 7, make Cars 3 featuring Flo. The cars get insured.
Number 6. Pay for Walt Disney's 65-year-old freezer bill.
It's building up, if you believe that. Number 5, produce the film Jimmy Carter in 3D.
Number 4, increase security around the Disney castle. i.e. alligator moat and snipers in the highest towers.
That's right, that's right. Number three, spay and neuter Pluto and get rid of all of his illegitimate offspring, including Scrappy-Doo.
Scrappy-Doo?
That's right.
He's one of them?
Yeah.
Number two, unthaw Walt Disney and reanimate his dead corpse.
In
3D. And the number one item that they could have done with $200 million, call animal control because all the Disney parks have dogs, mice, and ducks running rampant. That's the top 10 for the list of the week. Folks, stick around. We'll be right back after these messages with an undecided voter. Show everyone. With the November election fast approaching, we at BSU Tonight think we should help provide awareness for some of the choices you will have when you go to the ballot box in November. As we've stated in the top 10, we feel that all of these are nothing but cartoon characters running for the position. But because if there is one thing we've learned from Coney 2012, awareness is all that matters. So, who else to present their idea and their opinion but a rather everyday normal American schmo. I present the normal, undecided American voter.
Hi, everybody. It's me, your regular, everyday, undecided voter. You know, regular guy wearing my team's favorite colors, even though it's really warm outside. In fact, you know what? Makes me look like one of those hairless cancer kids. We're gonna scratch that. Excuse me. Let me tell you something. I am the undecided voter, and I am pissed. Let me tell you, with the upcoming election, I already want to stab myself in the stomach like one of them samurai guys in the movies that I've seen. Listen, first off, all I have to say to the Republican Party is, really? Really? You are presented with one of the weakest Democratic presidents since Jimmy Carter, and your response is Mitt Romney and Rick Santorum. It's, okay, it's like if your academic nemesis in grade school did a boring old volcano for their science fair project, and you responded with an even larger volcano that spewed even more bullshit. And/or Heinz ketchup. Speaking of ketchup, I swear to God, if you call me one more time while I am eating with my wife and kids, asking me to participate in some godforsaken over-the-phone town hall meeting or vote for you in the primaries, I will pop every single tire on your campaign bus and make sure that every single telemarketing service has your number so they can call you every single waking hour. Hello, would you like to buy some glass windows? People say you aren't very transparent with your political plans. Another thing that pisses me off, although I shouldn't call it a thing, it's more of a word, transvaginal exams. What are you thinking, Rick Santorum, even mentioning this? First of all, the term is way too scientific. Transvaginal? It sounds like something an alien or a TSA agent would do to you in a dark alleyway. Transvaginal? That's what Spock does to the linguistics girl on Star Trek. Even if you don't mean it, why bring it up? Because the next thing you know, you got a whole bunch of women's groups complaining about how it's not your job to look up their vajayjays. It's Herman Cain's. Anyways, then there's, what's his name? Mitt Romney, yes. What to say about Mitt Romney? Honestly, not that much. I don't know. I don't like the guy's face. Something about his face I don't like. Now, I may be saying a lot of things about Republican candidates right now, but there are a few things that I need to say about Mr. President Obama. And honestly, frankly, I can't get behind this man because, let me just say one thing. He's too much of the B word, people. Borrowing, okay? Borrowing, people. If he keeps borrowing at this rate, the only restaurants left in the United States will be Chinese buffets. And as much as I love the multitude of ways you can cook, fry, baste, and or fillet a chicken, those people don't know how to cook cow to save their life. And let's be honest with ourselves here. The only reason why Obama got elected is because of all those women in the back of the town hall meetings yelling, "What about my babies?" What about your babies? Paying for your babies anyways. I just want a president. I just want someone who will stop taking things away from me. Government continues to just grip down on the rights of everyday regular guys like me. Let's take my friend, for instance. He loves trans fats. You're just going to take that away from him? You know, it's people like you, that are responsible for Kentucky Grilled Chicken. You are the reason there's a tax on soda. And you're also the reason why there's now a skinny Jonah Hill. In the end, who do I really want as a president? I want a winner. I want someone who makes me feel happy and secure inside. Someone with a winning smile. And most importantly, a winning economic plan. A man that, if he was on Wheel of Fortune, would be like, "What are these bankrupt spaces doing here on this wheel? I don't go bankrupt, and neither does the United States of America." Yes. Sometimes, though, when it comes to political candidates, much like when you're browsing through Netflix and their choice of online streaming movies, all of your options suck. So, like I always say with my favorite team, there's always next year. And may God have mercy on the United States of America.
That was kind of an awful mistake on our part, excuse me. Anything you wanna say to that?
Meow, 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 meow.
The f*** was that? We'll be right back after this. I don't get it. What?
Timmy?
Not what it looks like.
Sitting on the toilet. Sitting on the toilet.
Have you ever heard the term glory hole?
I mean, just, you know, politics or just undecided voters in general?
Undecided voters are the scum of the earth.
It sounds like they're just complaining, just bitching and complaining. Oh, I don't know who to vote for. Just vote, you know?
Yeah.
I don't care. Like, I know who I'm voting for. Obama 2012. That's an official Zengi's Elderly endorsement.
Or don't vote. But don't be undecided.
Nah, you should vote. Even if you're just playing eeny, meeny, miny, moe on the ballot, you should still vote. It's just kind of good.
No.
I don't know. Maybe I'm not the right person, obviously, with the monologue. Maybe I'm not the right person to talk about politics.
Yeah. Exactly.
Well, our next guest, he needs no introduction. He's been quaking the place up as soon as he got here. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Jawan Edwards. Come on out! Oh, he's flying! Welcome to the show, man. Good to see you. Good to see you. Have a seat. Please sit down. How's it going?
Doing all right, man. Out here grinding, trying to get ready for next season.
Yeah, man, absolutely. So how long have you guys been? Have you just started, or have you been, you know, warming up and practicing for some time now?
Well, we got the winter break off, and soon we got back. It was time to grind, you know, start spring football next Tuesday.
And then you obviously going to do some work in the summer, you know, before the games start and all that, right?
Oh, yes, sir. Yes, sir, definitely. Morning workouts, lifting, you know, just getting ready for season.
That sounds awful. I'm going to be honest with you. That just does not sound like the lifestyle. I mean, I get up and read the paper and come here. That's my life, you know.
This is what you put your mind to. It's a mindset.
No, absolutely. I think it's great. I mean, now you got to tell me the nickname, the Quake.
Quake.
The Quake. How did that come about?
Well, you know.
You that force to be reckoned with?
Nah, I was big all my life, and then I started getting smaller and smaller. Started playing running back, and then I would start running through people, you know. So I developed that name on the field, and I just stayed with me.
Stuck with it. It's not a bad nickname, you know.
Sir.
I had some in the first grade. They were a lot less. They were awful. They were terrible. They really, you know, they were nicknames that you cried at night. Timmy, you had some of those, didn't you?
No.
Yes, you did.
No.
I can think of maybe two of them right now.
Butterball.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And Timmy. I won't say the other one. No, okay. I don't want to throw you off. This is his time. Okay.
Yeah.
Would you stop distracting
me? I'm just taking his camera time. Okay,
no, sure.
Sorry.
It's really wonderful to have you on the show. You're a hard man to get in touch with. I mean, you're really, really busy. I mean,
man.
We really appreciate having you on the show. You know, just, you know, overall with, you know, sports and everything at Ball State, do you feel that participation, you know, student participation, student, you know, involvement is, you know, is it a problem? Do you feel like with people showing up to games and events and stuff like that?
Oh, yeah, that is a problem. Like, when we win, y'all with us. When we lose, they're not with us. We just want some people that's be consistent. You know what I mean?
And really, it shouldn't. I mean, you would agree with me here that it doesn't matter on the win or the loses. It's the team. You support the team, and whatever happens, you can't win them all.
Yeah, but you know? With me on the field, you know, whoever shows up or not, I'm here to play. So you know,
absolutely, and that's your mentality. And it's not, you know, a few games out of the year, a few weekends out of the year. I mean, like you said, you get winter break off. Then you spend the rest of the semester training and lifting.
Yes,
then
sir.
You spend your summer training and lifting getting ready for it. This is a year-round thing for you.
Yes, sir.
And so a little bit of support. You know, we've had different athletes, student athletes come on the show in different areas, you know, club volleyball, you know, all just diverse areas, including just different events. And that's the thing. Attendance is low across the board. What do you think would just kind of be the best thing to get students to kind of come out and really be, you know, show that BSU pride?
Well, it always comes down to the team. You know, they want to see winners. They don't want to see losers, regardless of, you know, college or the next level. So we just got to do a good job, keep working hard.
And yeah, absolutely.
Get y'all fans to be on our back.
But and see, my whole thought with this is, it doesn't matter if you win or lose. You know,
yeah.
If you lose, you know, the participation should still be up at the next game. You know, we should still be out there supporting.
Well, that's the way it goes, man. That's just how it works.
That's how it works.
No, that is how it works.
You're gonna lose fans.
Yeah, yeah.
No, I wouldn't say that. I mean, look at the Chicago Cubs. 104 years, all right, and they still keep coming back, all right.
Yeah.
So don't sit there and tell me that a couple of losses and everything are going to hold the fans back.
Okay.
I don't like the Chicago Cubs. Let's just say that right now. So now you've had a whole, you know, I was, you know, people have been coming up to me when you came in the studio. Everyone's like, he's here.
Yeah.
He's here. I think you should go talk to him. I'm like, okay, I'm finishing this. They're like, you ask him about the Oklahoma game. Ask him about this game. So you, I mean, really, you've got like, I mean, you know, the kind of the vibe that the whole, you know, cast and crew is just kind of putting on right now. It's just like, is really excited. So Oklahoma game, you got knocked back pretty hard. Am I right?
Yeah, you know, I still dream about it to this day. You know,
really?
I'm just happy that I got my big hit out the way early, you know.
Yeah, yeah. And so, like, what, full force, knocked the helmet off, you know, knocked you back?
Just knocked the life out of me.
Really?
Like, I was on the sideline. People behind me was like, do you know where you're at? And like, 85,000 people, you know, it was a good, you know, experience. It's
and
okay,
so you didn't receive a concussion or anything off
no,
that,
sir, I wasn't hurt, just the wind knocked out of me.
Was,
I was back
no,
on
that. Ain't nothing but a thing. Just got up and kept moving. Right
Part
on,
the
right
game.
On. So just, you know, I mean, obviously you love football. Like, that's your passion. But, like, you know, what about the Juwan, the people that decide they don't know of you? Do you have any hobbies? Are you a scrapbooker? Do you like to knit? I mean, what is it that you
like
to do
stamps.
In your free time when you're not, you know, thinking about the game?
I'm not thinking about the game. Probably play a little video game. I'm good at basketball, people don't know that.
Okay, like to play the basketball.
And then, like, I was raised around a lot of special education kids, so I like to reach out to those. So
that's fantastic. Very cool. Very cool. That's awesome. So, well, you know, I think we're just about out of time here with the interview. But are there any shout outs you'd like to make? Anyone watching that could be watching? Any hopeful fans that are gonna, you know, sticking around for next season? Anything you'd like to say to them?
So all the BSU students, please come out and show your support. Chirp, chirp.
You heard it here first. Chirp, chirp. Come on out and support them. Support every team, every event on campus, because we need to stick together if we want to be a unified campus.
Yes.
I want to thank you so much for coming on the show. It's been wonderful having you. We will be right back after these messages, so please stick around.
Hey, girls. The first day of spring was this week, and that brings April showers and May flowers. But hey, leave your rain boots at home. They're really not cute. Polka dots, plaid, rubber duckies. Never acceptable. Take it from me.
It was awesome having him on the show, wasn't it?
Yeah,
Juwan
Edwards.
Yeah, that was a real treat to have him on the show. I mean, we've tried to get in contact with him before. He's just been a busy guy.
Lifting weights.
I didn't honestly think that they worked a whole year round to kind of do that.
Football players work hard.
Yeah, I'd like to thank the jackass undecided voter for coming on our show and complaining and filling up 5 minutes. That's always great, because when I turn on MSNBC or CNN, I don't get enough of it.
We like to waste time.
We like to waste a lot of time, apparently, which is what we're doing now. I've been told that if I walk off at the end instead of stay here and talk BS, I'm going to lose my job. So I say filibuster. We're going to start with A's in the phone book, and you can go ahead and roll the credits at any time, and we'll stay up here. Before I get to that, is this your hat?
No, it's not mine.
Is this hat was just here?
I think we found it.
Because normally we have a centerpiece. You stole it, didn't you?
I don't know. You should ask somebody else if they stole it.
Are you thinking of someone in particular?
No, not at all.
I
Maybe
hope
it was
not.
Caleb.
All right, fantastic.
Caleb looks like he would wear this
Abernathy,
hat.
Abernathy? Arbuckle? Alphabetical.
A-D?
A-B. Abernathy. A-B-B-R-I-T-H-N-A-Y.
Okay, you know, I don't need a spelling lesson.
Abernathy. It would be helpful if we had a phone book.
Now you have to say meow 5 times on camera.
Whatever.